Welcome back to the Shane Plays Let's Play series of the Pathfinder Kingmaker beta. This is now the beta, not the alpha. Last video was character creation, and now we're beginning, jumping right into the campaign, the story. You know, we appear to be in a, like a royal hall, a city clerk's area. I don't know. We'll see. Amiri! Where are they? This is taking forever. They didn't even say what this was for. Just that the Aldori were looking for heroes. Who are the Aldori anyway? Rich folk? So Amiri is the barbarian lady. And then this is my character, the Magus, Raceland P. Gygax Tuttleworth IV. Tartuccio. If you can't be patient, no one's keeping you here. Just go back to your mountains or whatever hole you crawled out of. The Aldori sword lords run the premier school for the dueling arts. They're also the richest and most influential group in this part of Brevoy. Take that tone with them, and they'll teach you some manners pretty quickly. So Tartuccio is around here somewhere. There he is. I guess that's who's talking. And if I remember right from the alpha, he ends up kind of being a bad guy. I don't remember if this was in the beta or not. I feel like it wasn't. You can hover over basically hypertext, and it will give you more information. Let's right-click and see what happens. Okay, interesting. I'm not going to go through all that, but that's nice. Okay, so let's continue. All right, you purple toad, just shut your trap. And if you can't, I'll help you. Amiri is rather short on tact. Lindsay, hush, quiet, they're coming. There's Lindsay. Now, in the alpha, you had to chase Lindsay down and find her. I don't remember the alpha starting this way. Maybe it did. I feel like we just started at like Olog's trading hut or something like that. Anyway, and as you see here, this is a beta test. It's 0.3.0. So this isn't even a 1-point release. Hush, quiet, they're coming. You get a little log over here of dialogue and combat and whatnot. Jamondi Aldori. Greetings, everyone. I am Sword Lord Jamondi Aldori, and this is my lord, this is Lord Mayor Yosef Selimius of Restoff. Welcome to my mansion. Okay. Yosef Selimius, the mayor, a middle-aged man with bushy sideburns and a monocle, wears a beaming smile. We thank you from the bottom of our hearts for responding to our call. You may be few, but that's unavoidable. We need only the best of the best for this task. And I see true heroes before me. Strong and fearless, exactly what Restoff needs. And Restoff is a large city in southern Brevoy. So Brevoy is the country or the region, and Restoff is a city. All right. Jamondi Aldori. Thank you, Lord Mayor. Now to the point. South of here, just beyond Brevoy's border, lies a region known as the Stolen Lands. This is disputed territory. And while it's long been claimed by nearby states, it's never truly been taken. I won't bore you with the legal technicalities. Suffice to say that anyone with enough courage and power to seize the stolen lands and name themselves Baron or Baroness, claiming dominion, well, none of the neighboring states would be able to challenge it. Of course, Restov would be first to recognize legitimacy of this new state, as well as the noble title of its founder, hence the Kingmaker Avenger path, I suppose. Jamondi continues, I don't know why this is so dark here. For the speaker's name, it's kind of hard to see, but anyway, this is a beta. Unfortunately, one serious obstacle stands between you and this title. A gang of bandits holds sway in the Stolen Lands. Their chief, who they call the Stag Lord, considers himself the rightful owner of these lands, and no one has yet been able to challenge his power. Bring me his head, and you'll be able to return to the Stolen Lands as their legal ruler. Any questions? Let's see. You're helping us found a barony. What do you gain? What rewards can we expect? Okay, why not just recognize the Stag Lord as a baron? Jethil. Looks like she's another adventurer there. That's a good point. As I see it, the Stag Lord already holds power over the region with confidence. Many noble bloodlines were started by bandits who just got lucky, weren't they? The Sword Lord's gaze is chilling as she responds. Perhaps because we do have standards to maintain. This room has seen many celebrations of adventurers, and even those who just got lucky. But giving a noble title to a bandit lord? That's one thing that's never happened here, and it won't while I still breathe. Okay? There's a whole team of us. Who exactly received the Baron's title? Tartuccio. I will, of course. I'm the leader of this team, after all. Don't worry, though. I'll make it worth your while to help me. Harem. He's the cleric, if I remember right. We haven't yet begun, and you already speak of divvying rewards. What makes you think you'll even succeed, or will even succeed? There's little point arguing over who gains the title. We'll most likely lose our lives there. Jumandi clears her throat loudly, interrupting the argument. If I may please answer the question. She takes a long pause, waiting for the voices to die down as everyone directs their attention toward her. We believe you're all equally deserving of a noble title. Over the course of your expedition, it will be up to you as a team to decide which of you is best suited to rule. Ooh, that won't lead to any Machiavellian backstabbing at all. You're helping us found a barony. What do you gain from such generosity? Tartuccio, don't ask stupid questions. Why should you even care what they have to gain and why? That's for Lady Aldori and I to discuss. It's none of your concern. Your only concern is to swing your sword around or whatever it is you do. Yeah, Tartuccio is already winning hearts and minds with his leadership abilities. Okay, so back to Jumandi Aldori. Of course, we stand to benefit from this enterprise, but if you're concerned that we intend to rule your country from afar, using you as a front, please know that these concerns are unfounded. Let's just say that we have a strong interest in the region's stability. We have need of a ruling power we can negotiate with, not bandit gangs and monster hordes. Okay, so what rewards can we expect exactly? The Lord Mayor's eyebrows rise so far he almost drops his monocle. What reward would you seek beyond a noble title in your own lands? Back to Aldori. We'll absorb the costs of preparing and equipping your expeditions. Once you return victorious, Restov will also allocate you a significant sum to provide financial support for you to establish your country. Essentially, we'll help you build your capital. I hope such a reward is satisfactory. Amiri, words. Significant financial. I can't fill my belly with pretty words. Jumandi smiles. Of course, there will also be an official banquet held in your honor. All of Restov's high society will gather to celebrate your feat. Amiri, now you're talking. Okay, so it's clear as day. Excellent. You venture forth tomorrow. For now, you can take some time to get to know one another better, or you can head straight to your guest rooms to get some rest. You'll find we've already prepared supplies for you there. And thank you again for agreeing to take part in this expedition. I wish you luck. And the mayor says, thank you again with all my heart for applying to this call. The flare in your eyes reveals your courage, the unshakable will that distinguishes true heroes. I look at you, O champions of Restov, and doubt not for a second that you'll be victorious. So venture forth towards your feet. Go and return in triumph. Okay. So, Lindsay. Hi, my name's Lindsay. I'm a bard, though this is my first real adventure. So shall we go teach this stag lord a lesson? Yeah, this is definitely different because last time we didn't get Lindsay until we caught up with Tartuccio in like some kind of tomb or underground dungeon. And she sort of, at least in the alpha, she was sort of the chronicler of the game. We sure will. Just wait. We have plenty of great feats in store. I'm Raceland P. Gygax Shuttleworth IV. Pleased to meet you. I'm going to say, I'm Raceland P. Gygax Shuttleworth IV. Pleased to meet you. Likewise, actually, I also wanted to ask you something. All right. How do you feel about this Tartuccio fellow? I think he's pretty obnoxious, personally. He appointed himself head of the team, and he's just after the Baron's crown, or whatever it is Barons wear. Doesn't matter. I don't like him. I think you should be team leader. When I first saw you, I couldn't help but think, now here's a real hero, someone who'll be praised in poems and songs. This, Lindsay blushes a little, this is the person I'll write my book about. Wait, a book? I should have led with this. Please, just let me explain. You know what the trouble with most heroes' biographies is? They're always written years later, based on the tales of, best case, people who saw things from the outside. Worst case, someone heard about it from their brother, who heard it from their friend, who heard it from their cousin, and so on. Adding a new batch of lies each time. Every time I read about a heroic journey, I think to myself, why didn't they just bring a bard with them to write it all down properly? Well, Lindsay, as Shane, I would say, because a lot of times you don't realize that you're a hero until people look back later and say, that person's a hero. And then I thought I could be that bard. I just needed to find a suitable hero and volunteer to follow along on their glorious adventure. Great plan, huh? And here we are with a heroic journey lying before us. Who's going to be the hero? Some dwarf who keeps muttering about how we'll all die? Maybe that horrific scythe lady? Or, gods forbid, Tartuccio? No way. Let's see. What about that barbarian? She looks pretty heroic. I think her name's Amiri. Oh, yeah, she's fantastic. You could tell she could tear a bear's head off with her bare hands, but her voice falls to a whisper. She kind of scares me, just a little. But I mean, her sword's twice as big as I am. She could cut me down without even noticing. Just thinking it a bit. All right, I'm sure you'll agree. All right, I'm gonna go to my room to write about tonight. See you in the morning. So, the first step on the road to glory, I must leave the hall. All right, so let's take a look at the journey. We have a long road ahead of us, but we all need to get a good night's sleep. Okay, so she's saying, I think Raceland P. Gygax Shuttleworth the Fourth is just the person I was looking for. So Lindsay is writing the journal. Okay. See if I can talk to anybody else. There's a random adventurer. Click on the click. Okay, so we're getting a tutorial help tips. Click on the place you want to walk to, and your character will start moving towards it. I'm gonna go talk to Jamondi Aldori, the sword lord here. She says, "Go get some rest." Let's see, Amiri. Finally, the idle talk's over. Can't wait to set out. All right, Tartuccio. Tomorrow, our glorious journey begins. Are you ready? I hope so. I don't need layabouts on my team. There's a random adventurer. Just simple bandits. We'll deal with them in no time. So we can kind of move around. Now, it's isometric, so.
Time becomes distance.
So the camera does not allow us to go 360, but it is 3D in an isometric kind of way, and there's that kind of you kind of see that Pathfinder style of art, almost cartoony but not quite. Jethil, what game is Jumanji playing? I'm not used to feeling like a pawn. So seems like I really can't talk to many people. And there's Harem. He was the cleric from last time. This expedition is surely doomed. It says to move the camera, use the WASD and arrow keys or press and hold the middle mouse button. So, all right. And you can zoom in and zoom out. Okay. Doesn't seem like much we could do here. Area exit. This is the icon to exit the current area. Okay. Yeah, I don't remember getting the tool tips last time. So let's go. Let's get out of here. Okay. Lindsay bursts into your room. She looks scared. Her face is smeared with soot, and she holds a weapon in her hands. Help! Help! What's going on? The mansion's under attack. We need to help. Some villains broke in and started killing everyone. I barely made it. Hurry, we have to help the guards fight off the attackers. We'll be cut down one by one. As if to lend credence to Lindsay's words, a scream echoes from the hallway. All right. This seems kind of familiar. Maybe we did do this in the alpha. You're not going anywhere. Hey, combat. General, combat happens in real time, but you can pause the game anytime to assess the situation. Press space. Dice rolls. Most of the game's mechanics are based on the Pathfinder role-playing game system and use dice rolls to determine the results of actions. The most common die has 20 sides and is used for both checks and attacks. When a battle starts, each combatant makes an initiative check. Okay, so we still do initiative. Combat is divided into rounds, with each round lasting 6 seconds. Attack roll, damage, article. Okay, this is basic.
I'll carve my name onto your flesh.
Pathfinder D&D stuff, pretty basic stuff. So I got an initiative of 16, and the bandit got an initiative of 11, so I will attack first. Now, I don't think I can do, because I'm not second level yet, so I don't think I can do my mages thing where I can use touch spells to go through my sword yet. Let's take a look at what I have in my inventory. I don't even know what I have in my inventory. Well, hello, inventory. It seems to have. There we go. All right. So what do I have here? I have like nothing. I have that shows him holding a rapier, but there's not actually a rapier. I've got studded armor. Oh, I do have a rapier. Okay. And an ever-burning torch. Okay. So, but I don't think. Here's my spell book. I can do Burning Hands, True Strike, Magic Missile, Shield. True Strike does what? You gain temporary. Okay, so I get a plus 20 roll. Oh, I haven't memorized my spells yet, have I? I guess I have to sleep. I don't have any spells I can cast, or do I? Let's go back. Do I have spells? I have cantrips that I can throw, but I need to rest so I can. Memorize my spells. I think I'll start with Magic Missile, which is always a good one. And True Strike. All right. So next time he rests, he'll get that. So I'm just gonna have to fight. Did some damage to him. He missed me. I'm just gonna move it just over to combat. You can see the combat log here. I'm missing. Got him. All right. First step on the road to glory. Follow Lindsay. All right. You can interact with various objects, such as the bodies of dead opponents, by clicking on them. All right. I don't know what this is. Oh, it looks like it's a quick bar. Okay. Oh, wow. Look at all that. Okay. Hotkeys. Chain shirt and a dagger. That's all. Let's see. Chain shirt is armor class 4. Studded leather is armor class 3. But I get an armor check penalty and an arcane spell failure. So I think I'm going to stick with my studded leather for right now. All right, let's go. Assassins are already here. Quickly, follow me. They got someone. We have to help. There's Tartuccio. It's Tartuccio. I don't have. Lindsay is on her own right now. I don't have control over her. Now what do I have here? Daze. Disrupt him dead. Ray of Frost. Charge. Arcane weapon enhancement. Okay. I'm gonna, I guess, enhance my weapon. What am I doing here? I guess. I don't know. How do I know that? Yeah, what's this? Spell combat. First level, the mages can expend one point from his arcane pool as a swift action to grant any weapon he is holding plus one enhancement. Okay, so how do I do that? The UI is definitely changed from the alpha quite a bit. I'm not saying that's bad, just saying it's changed. I don't know, what am I doing here? How do I cast it? I guess that's what I'm doing. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. Tartuccio, you're just in time. A bit longer and I'd have been. Ugh, I don't even want to think about it. Can you imagine what a terrible loss that would have been? But it's all right now. I'm safe, sound, and unscathed. Ready to lead you to victory. Yeah, he's a bad guy. Lady Jamondi's holding the line in the banquet hall. You know, the one she had us gathered in before? We need to make our way to her. And along the way, we'll try to save some of these dummies who are supposed to accompany us to the Stolen Lands. Hey, I got a ring of protection plus one. Speaking of dummies. The gnome looks back at Lindsay and starts whispering as he takes a ring off his finger, handing it to you. Take this ring, quiet now, so that little fool doesn't hear it. She might try to steal it herself. It's magical, it'll protect you. You'll need it while you work to defend me. This guy's a piece of work, speaking of work. Alright, press I to open the old inventory. So now I have a ring of protection. Armor class increases by one. That's a deflection bonus and does not stack with other deflection bonuses. So, got my AC up to 17. I'll take that. All right. Where are we going? Let's check these guys out. Collect all. Yeah, my guy's running, moving pretty slow. I think there's some kind of bug where people can move slow even though they're not burned. They're not burdened yet, or encumbered. Block from the other side. In fact, let me check my How do I know what my... I'm 87.6 out of 106, I guess, on my encumbrance. And I have 411 gold pieces.
Time becomes distance.
Where am I supposed to go? By goodness, by gum. Oh, there's somebody dead. They didn't have a good day. Yeah, bow. Yeah, let's take all that.
Step, step, step.
Yeah, somebody got killed in their sleep. Poor guy. Never sleep the night before an adventure. At least not without a really good guard or
What's in wait
in a
for me
really
around?
secure place. Can I go in here? What is all this? Tab does seem to highlight interactable thingies.
Trail me.
Well, look, now Lindsay's in my party, and also Tartuccio, I guess. He won't stay there long. Like I said, he's a block from the other side. All right, should I go through here? Let me get everybody. Companions. There are several companions in our party now. To select a single character, click on their portrait or press corresponding key, etc., etc. All right, pretty standard stuff. Wonder what the save mechanic is in here. I'm gonna delete my old alpha test because this stuff won't load. Right, new save.
Step, step, step.
What do you got? You got a crossbow. What do you got? You got a. I don't know if a bow is meant for you or not, but I guess we can give you a longbow for your secondary weapon. And from the alpha, Lindsay is a very roguish kind of bard. Let's see if I can.
Shall we move?
What can I do
We
here?
shall move.
Ray of Frost. Daze.
Okay,
Right.
we'll do it the hard way.
Did he make a save? He saved on his saving throw, so I did not daze him. Let's see if I can do an acid splash on him. Advanced combat spells. Lindsay and Tartuccio are capable of casting spells. Okay. Abilities. Most characters have unusable abilities and attacks of opportunity. By holding down enter while the game is paused, you can make time move slowly for better combat control. I like that. Some actions perform. I wish this was tabby. I mean, I think D&D and, Pathfinder, which is a fork of D&D, it should be turn-based tactical combat. I don't understand why real-time will pause is, I know Baldur's Gate and all that, and everyone loved it, but I just don't get it. The combat is for turn-based tactical. But I don't know. I mean, I've gotten a little bit more used to real-time with pause over the years. And there's some about attacks of opportunity, which, you can provoke an attack of opportunity. Now I'm going to hit enter. Oh, so while you're paused, you can hit enter for like a. Okay, that's cool. It'll just kind of step it forward a little bit. Oh, I guess he's already dead? No, what happened? I see blood everywhere. Did Lindsay get? I think Lindsay got hit. Lindsay deals 8 damage to Assassin Bowman and he dies. Oh, she took out the Bowman back here. Look at all that blood. I really like that. That enter thing just steps it forward a little bit. Very nice. Okay. You acid splash this chump. Yeah, what spells do they have? She's got ear piercing scream, daze, charge. What does he have? He's got a lot of burning hands, disrupt undead. Is he a magus? As what is he? A wizard? What is Tartuccio? Oh, look, he sees chaotic evil. It's already giving it away. Let's see. He's a chaotic evil sorcerer. She's a chaotic good bard, and I'm a neutral good magus. All right, so let's take these guys out. All right, he's down. Each character has a certain number of hit points. When a character's hit point drops to zero, they lose consciousness. After combat is over, they'll get up and can be controlled. As a character's HP value could drop into negative numbers. If a character is reduced to a negative amount of hit points equal to its constitution score, the character dies. To resurrect them, you will need a special spell. Okay. Restore lost hit. Okay, healing spells, potions, or rest. Da-da-da. To use expendable items such as scroll, potions, or rods, open your inventory and place them in a quick spot. Okay. Do we have any expendable items? I don't think we do. I don't think we have anything expendable yet. Now, we do have some scrolls here. What do you have expendable? Cure light wounds and cure moderate wounds. I don't know if Bard could do that. I guess it's a Pathfinder thing. I don't know. And he's got a potion of cure light wounds. So, all right. She's the only, well, they're both hurt a little bit.
And Lindsay was called forth.
All right, where is your equipment? Where's your quick?
Anything is possible.
Where's your quick slot? That's an ability. That's a spell book. And that's the belt. Okay. So we're gonna cast that. All right. On yourself.
Serves you right.
Yes.
All right. She's healed up.
What's new?
You're gonna give that to him. Can we? Can we give up? Hold on. There's your inventory. Oh, can I not take it out? I can. Okay. And now I'm gonna give it to him. Oh, I see. Alright, put it in your belt. There we go. And now you're gonna drink it.
Quick, else we miss all the fun.
Okay. I'm gonna assume that F5 is quick save. We're on the core rules, I should point out, which is the basic rules of Pathfinder. Advanced rules are slightly harder, but we're on the core rules. Where are the hotkeys? Controls. Quick save, F5. Okay, let's do that real quick. Actually, let's check the treasure. Oh, wow, look at all that. Cure light wounds everywhere. Padded armor. Short bows. Collect all. All right, now let's save. You know, this game was really polished as an alpha. And I would say, you know, it continues to be polished. I know there's some bugs and stuff like that, which is to be expected in a, a beta. But, it's pretty... Oh, there's... Okay, this is the door that was locked from the other side, so... What's in here? Oh, dead people. Never sleep the night before an adventure. Is everyone else dead? Hopefully not. If you do sleep the night before an adventure, have somebody get in your back. It's very important. Oh, it's a chest. So when you hit tab, like with most games, you can see what's interactable. Hide armor and a heavy mace. How are we doing on... Alright, we're doing okay on... I guess it does a combined loot for everybody. Everybody's carrying capacity. Alright. Man, everybody is dead. It's not good. $35 gold and a silver ring. Man, I will... You know, I'm one of those RPG players, even if I'm the good guy. If it's not dealt down, I'm taking it. Unless there's an obvious in-game penalty. Oh, who is this? Amiri. Okay, so that's my barbarian friend who we definitely want to help. Yeah, let's go in here and help her out.
Can you make an epic pose? I need inspiration.
Yeah, she's all berserk, I guess, because she's all outlined in red. Amiri, the barbarian's face is distorted with rage. She grinds her teeth. Sweat drips from her forehead. Noticing Tartuccio, she swings her sword but stops it just in time. There's a little bit of foreshadowing. Oh, it's you. Stay out from under my feet or I'll strike you down. Amiri takes a deep breath and then barks out, "Blood for Gorom!" Swinging her bloody sword, she runs towards the sound of battle. And Gorom is a god of battle over all other pursuits. Okay, I like the little hypertext with the tooltips. Tartuccio, barbarians. Lindsay, I think that's exactly how heroes should be. Tartuccio, what? Stupid, sweaty, and always looking for something to gobble up or lop the head off of? Callistria, save me from such heroes. Callistria is the goddess of lust and revenge who takes on many faces and guises. She's held in especially high regard by elves who often identify with her moods and changeable nature. Huh. The savored sting. Hmm. All right. There they are. The assassins. This is your last chance to give up. Drop your weapons and we'll spare your lives. How generous. I'm afraid I can't offer you the same. Hey, ugly mug. Get them. Oh, who the heck is that? Oh, dang. Yeah, he definitely... This definitely was not in the alpha. Alrighty then. Well, I think that is a great place to... He's a frost giant. He dealt 53 damage. He threw Cone of Cold. Well, those poor guards.
Time becomes distance.
And what's that? Potion of Enlarged Person. Heck yeah! I'll be fighting a giant with that. I need to give it to that barbarian and let her do some fighting. Can I not get through here? What am I supposed to do now? What is this? The passage is blocked. You can't make it through this way. I guess the giant knocked it down or something. All right, here we go. Do we have a map? We do have a map. Okay. Jumanji Aldori's mansion. What is this? Shows exits. Show points of interest. What is this? Show significant objects. Okay. Whoa, what's all this? Sometimes interacting with an object requires a skill check. Okay, so what skill check did I do? Dexterity check succeeded. I don't know what I did. Oh, I guess it was to get past this. We had to do a dexterity check. So it says dexterity succeeded. What did I roll? Trying to get that to... Can I see what I did? I can't see the roll. I saw it for a second, but it's not staying up.
I see blood! Blood!
Assassins everywhere. So, his initiative, he rolled 10. 8 plus 2. My initiative check was 9. Or her initiative check was 9, and then mine was ridiculously good. I rolled a 20. I rolled as good as I could on initiative. Okay. Everybody attack. How many assassins are there? There's a bowman. Let's take out the bowman. can you do here? I'm going to buff up his weapon again, I guess. What is this? Yeah, you do your scream. What spells do you have here? Jolt. Jolt this guy. All right, take this guy out. Oh, he's already down. All right, everybody take this guy out. Looks like because the first opponent went down, that they changed their target to the next opponent, if I'm understanding right, which I like that. I like that a lot. Because, you know, I hate that when you're like, oh, well, that's already the action I committed to. Oh, well, the first opponent's dead, but I'm just going to waste that action or spell on them. Yeah, I've always thought that was stupid.
Amateurs.
Seems kind of dark. I don't know if I have a... I don't know if I have a gamma issue or what. Let's go into the graphics here. I don't know. I think I'm going to take the gamma up just a little bit. I think it's just a dark corridor. Can I go this way? An armory. I'm sure Jumanji wouldn't mind if we borrowed some weapons, right? I mean, I'm pretty happy with my rapier, but is this the armory? What do we have here? Yep. So you hit the tab key and it'll highlight everything that's available. What is that? A shield? I don't know if I'd want a shield, to be honest. I'm thinking that he wouldn't want a shield. I could be wrong. I still don't quite get the mages. What is that? A watchkeeper's key. Yeah, I'll take that. Tartuccio looks at the chest at the table and rubs his hands together. What have we here? This chest is full of gold. I guess it's the guard's salaries, all things considered. Well, those freeloaders don't seem to have been working too hard for it. Maybe we should pocket it instead. What? No, we're heroes, not thieves. Who said we were stealing it? We'll just take the gold for safety, so the assassins don't get it. And then we can heroically return it to Jumanji when this is all over. I'll say stealing from a sword lord in her own mansion, she'd have her heads. How would she know it was us and not the assassins? And so, unless someone planned on telling her, he throws a sideways glance at Lindsay. Don't drag me into this. You do what you want, but I'm not taking a single coin. I'm not going to take any of it. All right. I know this. I think this game will sort of modify your alignment as you go along. All right. Let's see. I don't really know if I need anything over here. Let's see what else we have. A composite longbow. Heck yeah, I'll take that. A light mace. Let's see what we're... Is this to a... Oh, what is this? Banded mail. Ooh, that armor class penalty is pretty awful. Armor class. Or armor check penalty. Breastplate. Yeah, I don't want it for any of my guys. Alright. Let's get out of here.
Forwards! No, backwards! Backwards!
I chose the mad voice, not because I think my character is mad, but because it was the voice I liked the best. I'm probably needing to go through that door, but let me go see what's over here. Nothing. All right. Oh, familiar faces. The pale elf looks eerie in the semi-darkness, like a ghost given flesh. I hope you're not so frightened as to swing at every shadow. It's me, Jaethal. I don't recommend advancing down the hallway, assuming you value your life, of course. There were a few people with me, and you can see what happened with them, or to them. And just how did they all end up dead, while you don't seem to have a scratch? Tartuccio eyes Jaethal suspiciously. I'll answer but briefly, and just once. Further scares and explanations will wait until we aren't being hunted by a group of assassins. Deal, all right? I'm undead. These traps are deadly to the living, but they're harmless to me. An undead elf. What do you mean undead? Like zombies or skeletons or... Jethel looks at Lindsay as though an annoying fly. As I said, further explanations will wait until later. All you need to know right now is that we're on the same side and we have to fight off a small army of hired assassins. Let's get to it. So now I have her. What does she do? You'll encounter many traps on your adventures. When any of your characters approaches a trap, they will automatically make a perception check. On success, you will see the trap's location. Having identified a trap, you can click on it in order... For one of the characters to make a thievery skill check to disable it. If the result of a skill roll is less than a trap's difficulty by 5 or more, the trap will go off as if the character had triggered it. Okay. Alright. So what are you? You are an inquisitor. I don't even know what an inquisitor is. I don't know if there... Does the journal have a lore book in it? I don't know what you do, sweetie, but we will check it out. When you hear the sound go out, that's me doing a... Oh!
I spy. What do I spy?
Who has the best thievery? Your trickery is, too. I don't have anybody with good thievery, unless they mean trickery. What is your thievery? Do you have thievery? Nope. Huh. Oh, trickery, not thievery. So whoever has the best trickery, I guess, automatically does it. So her trickery is +2. Mine's +2. Ominous Alliance. She's neutral evil. Yeah. Oh, wow, it takes 2,000 to get to level 2. Yeah, it talks about shifts. Alignment shifted to neutral, good. Alignment shifted to... How did I go to neutral? When did I go to neutral? When did that happen? But I guess I'm neutral good right now. This will actually kind of track your alignment as you go. You can say what your alignment is, but the game will make a record of what it thinks your alignment really is as you go. And I like that a lot. I've always liked alignment as part of the D&D system. Well, it looks like I'm going to do it, because we both have trickery +2. I got it.
Oh, did you see that?
Yeah. I needed a DC 10, and I got a 10. So, just enough.
No secrets can escape my prying gaze.
Oh, I triggered it. Let's see. I rolled a 4. I needed a 10, so I failed by more than 5. I failed my... will saving throw with an 11. I needed a 12, and I took 2 damage. It was a very nice loot. What is this? Scroll of Bless and a Scroll of Shield of Faith. All right. Let's see. Do I have use magic device? Let me go to... I do have +2 on music, use magic device, and Lindsay has +7, so she has a much better chance of using, I guess as a bard, she has a better chance. Bless, and I guess she could do divine and arcane, which is interesting. That might come in handy. Shield of Faith, shimmering magical field around the target that averts and deflects attacks. +2 deflection bonus to AC, etc. What is this? Expeditious Retreat. Buffs up your speed. Alright. What are you dallying for? I'm telling you, Jumanji's cache has to be here somewhere. Well, hurry it up before... Stop! Someone's coming! I really kind of wanted to go in there, but what do you do, Jethel? What is your thing? Oh, you got the scythe. Okay, you are the creepy scythe woman. And then my guy, he's got a longbow. I'm going to give him the composite bow now. All right. Everybody attack! Oh, shoot. Well, I was supposed to be on a... Oh, I didn't switch his stuff, did I? I meant to put him on a bow, and I didn't. Oh, well. Let him attack. Why? I guess she can't get in there. She doesn't have enough room. Get in there and fight, woman. Undead creepy scythe woman. What did they say about a cache? Curious. All right, first I want to go over here to the store. Yeah, what's all this? What's all this then? Huh. More assassins. Yeah, it looks very cool. Is that not like kind of a stag lord looking thing? Is that kind of some kind of a hint? Kind of foreshadowing? I don't know. Let's go.
What's in wait for me there, I wonder?
Is this it? What is this? Oh, what the heck? Huh. It appears to be a puzzle. And are there any hints? Let's see. Huh. That one's pointing down, that sword? I don't know. Let's see. Huh. Yeah, I don't get it. I like the smoke effect coming off the candles. That's nice. It seems like that pressing either one of them does the same thing. Yeah. I don't know. There may be some secret here, but I'll be darned if I know what it is. I don't know. All right. I want to go back out here and fight these other guys. There's Harem, my cleric. Let's try to cast some spells. What spells do we have here? Divine Favor. Huh. Yeah, she'll throw that. What is that? Inflict light wounds. All right. You're going to throw that thing on your sword. And you're going to do an ear piercing scream. And you're going to attack. All right. So at least one person did a fortitude save on that ear piercing scream. I guess he tried to run and we got a tax of opportunity on him. Let's go get some loot. What is that? A club? Yeah, I'll just take the potion of cure light wounds. This guy's over here whining. He's like, oh! Dialogue skill check. Sometimes skills are checked over the course of dialogue, for example, when trying to convince a character of something. Okay. A dwarf is lying on the ground, staring into the dark sky. He doesn't seem to have any severe wounds, but he's trembling, whispers weak as though he is at death's door. Groitus, I can sense your silhouette hovering over me. It won't be much longer. Soon we shall meet, O Lord of Oblivion. So he's the god of the end times. All right. See, diplomacy 12. Aren't you being a bit premature? Look at yourself. You barely got a scratch. Quit the axe and a fight, or I'll really send you to funerals. I'll try diplomacy. Succeeded. What did I roll? Oh, I got a 25. I got a 16 plus 9 skill value. See, I got that persuasion. That's impossible. Dwarf lifts his head and inspects his body carefully, then tries to move his hands and feet. It seems you may be right. Dwarf grunts as he regains his feet and warily looks down his blood-stained armor. It seems I will live. I suppose I must postpone my meeting my god. Not for long, I'm sure. But while we remain in this transient world, Harrelm is at your service. Good. I need my cleric. Spell conversion. Clerics and druids can convert their spells spontaneously. A cleric of good alignment doesn't need to prepare healing spells. They can spend almost any prepared spell to cast a cure spell at the same level. In the same way, a cleric of eagle alignment doesn't need to prepare inflict spells. During character creation, clerics of neutral alignment can choose whether their converted spells cure or inflict. A druid can convert almost any prepared spell into summon nature's ally at the same level. Okay, so how do I do it? How do I convert it? Because like with other games, I guess I just press up and I can convert. Nice. So other games, like other D&D games, you had to hold down like control or click or something like that. All right. Come along. I've got my cleric now. That's always good. And here you can stealth if you want to try to hide in shadows. So I could try to stealth her and get that little silhouette. And I can change their AI. So I can either turn the AI on or I could deactivate AI. So it doesn't seem to be any granularity within AI settings. Formations. Group formation is half of any victory. Formation system will help you hold the line in combat. Click this button to select one of the standard formations. You can also create your own. So I'm not a big formations guy. I probably should be, as much as I talk about how much I like turn-based tactical combat, but this is what they're talking about. The default formation. You know, or I can change my own. I can put, you know, how does this work? How do I make my own? Press shift to snap to the grid. I guess these are custom. These three are custom. So I could say, I want her in front. Actually, I want him in front. My battle cleric. And then I want her in the middle. She's kind of melee. Actually, I'll put him in the middle. I'll put her up front with me. I'm not sure exactly what an Inquisitor is, but she has a big scythe or a scythe. And I'll put those two in back. So I'm going to choose that. Oh, it didn't. Did it? Oh, it did save. Okay. All right. So I can go. I want that one. Let's see if that works. Well, wait a minute. I'm missing somebody. There we go. All right. So I'm going to switch to that. Yeah, there, it's working. That's what I told it to do. I normally don't mess with formations, but sure, why not? Like I said, when you hear the sound turning off, I'm quick saving. I am a save scummer. I am. I always have been. Guard. I figured there was a big battle coming up because they were talking about formations. That's what I get for metagaming. I always give my players and my tabletop D&D group, I'm like, don't meta game. All right, let's see what's going on. Let's go talk to Keston. Keston Garris. The stout man's unshaven face is covered with scars. There's blood on his armor, but he doesn't even seem to notice his wounds as he confidently gives orders to the guards. You! Run and get an axe. You, bring more water. You stay here and hold our defenses. Those assassins are still around here somewhere. Keston Garris turns to you. Ah, some of our guests survived. Good. You need to get to the banquet hall and help Lady Jumandi. Do you need help putting out the fire? No, we'll manage. I've got my best people here. Those who still live. Your place is by Lady Aldori's side. Who are you? Keston Garris. House Garris is based in the western part of Bravoid. A fighter in the service of Sword Lord Jumandi Aldori. Right now I'm in charge of the mansion guards. As you can see, there's a lot to do. All right, where's the hole? You'll have to run through the fire. We've almost put it out at the entrance. Your main concern should not be to inhale any smoke. Hold your breath and take the first right, then head straight down the hallway. I'll go immediately. May Adabar, the god of cities, law, merchants, and wealth. Okay. So I'm supposed to run through the fire? All right, let me go back over here. Because there's some stuff over here I didn't finish out. See, it's interesting to me. Because the Stag Lord kind of looks like this, from what I understand. These statues. So I don't know if that's a hint that things are not all as it seems. I just don't know. Oh, look, we've got more of these. So maybe this is more of the puzzle. Ah, look at all this. These are both down. So I guess everybody needs to be down. Not sure that I understand. So these two are connected. These two are connected. This one's not connected. Up. Down. Down. Well, everybody's down. Does that mean... Well, I don't know. I don't have any... I don't have any hints as to how this is supposed to be. I've got everybody down. Maybe it's supposed to be down, up, down, up. Down, up, down. No, that's down, up, down, up, and nothing's happening. I don't know. Now they're both synced. Now they're in sync. Before they were different. I don't know. Alright. I'm gonna mess around with this a little bit more, but I really don't feel like it's late. I'm tired. Okay, maybe the shields on the wall behind them are hints. Okay, so they're both up. So we gotta get them both up. That didn't make any difference. I was thinking maybe these shields behind them on the wall were a clue. But, oh, nope, that one's down now. Let me just leave one guy over here. No. Stay. Just you go over here. Everybody else come back here. I don't understand. I don't see really any hints here. No, go back that way. You. Both down. Both up. Oh, look. It's changing. Oh, they're changing it in here, too. See these? Do they all need to go one way or the other? I'm assuming maybe they all need to go up. So those are all up. I would just, no, no, you stay there. I'm thinking all up is the way to go. No, no, just stay there. Stay there. No, stay there. You, go there. You, go back that way. Ah, dang it. Okay, so I'm guessing let's try to get all the swords up, like in a salute. I don't know. Okay. You.
So many thoughts, so little time. Let's shake a leg.
No, no, you stay here. I really need to like write out a grid of what does what. I'm just kind of flowing around here. I'm gonna pause the video while I fiddle around with this. All right, it's getting late. This video's over an hour. I think I'm gonna end here. Maybe sleep on it and see if I can figure out. This in the morning, but I'm not gonna, or the next time I play, I'm not gonna spend a whole lot more time on it. Anyway, thanks for watching the Pathfinder Kingmaker beta. As we play it through, significant differences from the alpha, both in the game content and in the UI. I'm enjoying it, so you know, please feel free to leave comments and thumbs up on the video. That helps me out a lot. And feel free to leave advice or questions or comments or whatever in the video comments, and let's make it interactive. Anyway, we will catch you next time on Shame Place.